The Cochlear Nucleus and Osia MRI kits are intended to prevent the dislodgement of the internal magnet in a cochlear brand implant. This video is supplemental to the applicable or relevant MRI kit user guide. For complete instructions, warnings, and precautions related to MRI for each implant type or model, please visit cochlear.us/MRI. The instructions for use require that the kit be applied by an ENT physician. Steps to wrap. Hair management. Have the carer or recipient tie their hair in a way that allows for access to the implant site. Removing the sound processors. The sound processor cannot go into the MRI exam room and must be removed prior to applying the wrap. Please keep in mind the recipient may no longer be able to hear once the processor is removed. Apply the chin strap. Select the appropriate chin strap size and place the center of the chin strap over the chin and bring forward the two ends of the chin strap with hook and loop fastener. Place a round magnetic splint over the chin strap over the relevant implant sites and use a marker to draw the outline of the splint on the fabric chin strap. Repeat if bilateral. Note, the 600 series and the OSI 300 series do not need an MRI kit applied. Insert the round splint under the chin strap, directly under the drawn markings. Starting at the base of the skull, begin wrapping around the forehead, maintaining tension. Bandage firmly enough to keep the magnets secure, but not so firm that it will cause pain or discomfort. Continue bandaging until the entire bandage has been used. Do not cut the bandage. And carefully press hands around the bandage to ensure layers have adhered and the wrap is secure. Stop and check that the patient is comfortable, that there is one anchor wrap at the base of the skull, that one wrap is around the middle back of the head, that the splint is completely covered and no blue is visible, and that the entire bandage has been used. Conduct the MRI scan. Consult the MRI guidelines for the specific scanning conditions based on the recipient's implant type. Removing the wrap. After the patient has left the MRI room, remove the MRI kit components and ask the patient to put their sound processors back on. Please confirm that placement of the sound processor is correct, that there is no discomfort, that sound is perceived as normal, and if any issues are reported, please ask the patient to seek assistance from their implant clinician as soon as possible. Dispose of the kit as they are single use. Pain and discomfort is a possibility that the recipient should be aware of. Pressure, pulling, or heating is a possibility. However, the procedure should be terminated if pain grows to a level that the recipient is uncomfortable with. Consider local anesthesia. Local anesthetic may be applied to reduce discomfort. Take note to not perforate the implant silicone. Confirm specific implant model and scanning conditions. If unsure, please contact Cochlear for this information. It is helpful to minimize the time between application of the kit and the MRI scan. Counseling about the procedure prior to sound processor removal is key, as the recipient will be unable to hear once removed. This video is supplemental to the applicable or relevant MRI kit user guide. For complete instructions, warnings, and precautions related to MRI for each implant type, please visit cochlear.us/MRI.